Good morning, girls. We are in continuation of a chapter number 11, that is reproduction in plants. And today we will discuss about the vegetative propagation. As I told you in our earlier video, what do you mean by vegetative propagation? It means the reproduction in the plants through vegetative parts. There are vegetative parts in the plant, roots, stems, etc. Through these, they give rise to the new plants. Okay, that is called vegetative propagation. So, vegetative propagation can be done by natural means. This we will not do. This portion is cancelled. So, here vegetative propagation by natural means, this is cancelled. We will not study this in this class. Okay, till here. We will study about the vegetative propagation by artificial means. Right? So, let's do that. By artificial means, there are four methods. There are four different kinds of methods through which the plants, they can give rise to the new plants. Okay. These all are through the vegetative parts, either through stems, either through roots, or through the other parts. We will study that. The first method is cutting. What happens in cutting? See, in cutting, what happens? The stem of the plant is cut, right? We cut a stem of a plant and we sow it in the soil, okay, right? So we what do? We just sow that in that soil and we put water in it. We give sunlight to it. After some time, what happens? The cut stem, this eventually develops into a new plant, right? For example, here is hibiscus. What do you do in hibiscus? We can cut a stem from the already developed plant. We can sow it in the soil and we put water and we can put some fertilizers. We can add manure to it and then slowly and slowly it will grow into a new plant. This is simply cutting. Cutting of a stem and sowing it in the soil. Second method is grafting. What is done in grafting? Now, here what happens? We involve two plants. Here two plants of the same species, right? It is not that one is the species of let us say mango and the other species is the other one, for example, any other plant, apple. No, we will take the same species but two plants. Mango only, but two plants we will take, okay, of same species. Now what happens in this? We cut a bud or a stem is cut from one plant. Okay, we cut a stem or a bud. Then what happens? Then we insert, this is a stem which has been cut. See, this is a cut stem. And we insert this stem into the groove of the other stem. This is the other stem of the other plant and we make a cutting here. See, you can see this is a cut part here. We will insert this stem into this stem. Got it? And this stem, which is the cut part, which has been cut from one stem, that is called scion, right? And the second plant in which it is getting inserted, see, there is one where there is a cut part here. Where it is getting inserted, that is called stalk. So one is the cut part here, which is getting inserted into this. This is scion, the stem which has been cut. And the other where the cutting has been made. This is not cut, where the cutting has been made and this scion is inserted in this stalk. Okay. So see, you can see in the figure here. This has been inserted in this. Okay. And now what happens? This grafted area, this new grafted area, grafted means the way we have inserted this, this inserted thing, this whole thing is then covered with a layer of the soil. We cover it with the soil and then we add water to it, we add manure to it and slowly it develops into a new plant. Okay, so it will develop into a plant. Now what is the use of this? Why can't we simply cut the stem and we can put it in the soil like we are doing in cutting and then we can grow? See, what happens is, suppose there are two different trees of the same species like mango only. One is giving a fruit of very large size. ओके, बट दैट फ्रूट इज नॉट सो डिलिशियस, नॉट सो जूसी. द अदर वन इज वेरी जूसी बट द साइज इज नॉट ग्रोइंग. वी वॉन्ट बोथ द एडवांटेजेस, सो इन दैट केस वॉट वी विल डू, वी विल कट द स्टेम ऑफ वन एंड वी विल टेक द स्टेम ऑफ द अदर ऑल्सो. विल मेक अ कटिंग हेयर एंड वी विल इंसर्ट बोथ ऑफ देम. वी विल इंसर्ट दिस इन टू दिस एंड वी विल सो इट इन द सॉइल. वी विल वॉटर इट, एड मेन्योर टिल इट डेवलप्स इन टू अ न्यू प्लांट. सो इट विल हैव द एडवांटेजेस ऑफ बोथ द स्पीशीज, बोथ द प्लांट्स. सेम स्पीशीज ओनली, मैंगो ओनली विल डेवलप, मैंगो ट्री विल ओनली डेवलप, बट इट विल हैव एडवांटेजेस ऑफ बोथ द थिंग्स. ओके, सो वेराइटीज ऑफ फ्रूट बेरिंग ट्रीज आर डेवलप्ड बाय ग्राफ्टिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल मैंगो, एप्पल. सो दिस इज द एडवांटेज ऑफ ग्राफ्टिंग. वी कैन हैव डिफरेंट एडवांटेजेस, वी कैन हैव डिफरेंट वराइटीज बाय डूइंग ग्राफ्टिंग. नाउ द थर्ड इज लेयरिंग. वॉट हैपन्स इन लेयरिंग? नाउ लेयरिंग इट इज मेनली डन इन द लाइक इन द प्लांट्स लाइक जैस्मीन विच हैव द लॉन्ग स्लेंडर स्टेम्स. ओके, विच हैव लॉन्ग थिन स्टेम्स. हाँ, सो वॉट डू वी डू? वी द स्टेम इज ग्रोइंग, सो वी पुट वन पार्ट ऑफ द स्टेम, वी सो द स्टेम इन टू द सॉइल. वी कवर इट विद द सॉइल, वी पुट सॉइल ऑन इट एंड देन वी पुट अ ब्रिक ऑन इट सो दैट इट गेट्स सबमर्ज इन टू द सॉइल ओनली, इट डजेंट कम आउट. वी हैव नॉट टेकन, वी हैव नॉट कट इट फ्रॉम द प्लांट, इट इज स्टिल विद द प्लांट ओनली. ओके, इट इज स्टिल विद द प्लांट ओनली, द स्टेम इज ग्रोइंग. वी हैव सोड और वी हैव पुट अ पार्ट ऑफ द स्टेम, वी हैव इंसर्टेड द स्टेम इन टू द सॉइल एंड वी हैव पुट ब्रिक ऑन इट सो दैट इट इज कंप्लीटली सबमर्ज इन टू द सॉइल. देन वी एड वॉटर टू इट, वी रेगुलरली वॉटर इट. देन वॉट हैपन्स? Then the roots, they start coming out from the stem. Here, the roots, they start developing. Once the roots have been developed and the shoot also, the stem also start developing. Shoot is a stem, you know that. Then it can be cut from here, from the parent plant. And then it grows into the new plant. Got it? First, we do not cut it. First, we just insert it into the soil. We water it. We put a brick on it. And then when the roots and the shoot system, they develop from here, then we cut it from the parent plant. So this is called layering. Layering means putting it in the soil. Okay. Now, fourth method is the tissue culture. What happens in tissue culture? Tissue culture, the growing tips of the plant are cut. The plant is growing, right? Here is the plant. So we cut a portion, the top portion of the plant, the tip of that. And they are planted in an artificial medium kept inside a conical flask or a test tube. We are not inserting in the mud. We are not growing it naturally. What we are doing, we put them into the flask. Conical flask is there or a test tube is there. Then the medium provides all the necessary nutrients for the plant growth. We put water in it. We give the temperature to it, the proper temperature to it. And we put manure to it. All the necessary things that are needed. And once the roots are developed, they are planted in the suitable soil. Then they are taken it out from here and they are planted in the soil. Okay. So, these are the different methods of artificial means of vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation means reproduction through the vegetative parts. And artificial means, we have done cutting, simply cutting the stem and sowing in the soil. Grafting, when the two plants of the same species, they are taken, the stems of the two plants are taken and they are inserted with each other. Then layering, when the stem, long thin stems of a plant, they are inserted into the soil without cutting. After that they are cut. And last is a tissue culture, where we take the tip of the plant and then we put it in the flask or the test tube and we give all the natural temperature etc. And then they grow and then we put it in the soil. Okay. Now, what are the advantages of vegetative propagation? Vegetative propagation is very useful for plants growers as they can get large quantities of new plants in short time. The newly reproduced plants have the exact characteristics of that of the parent plants. Since we are taking it from the parent plant, so they will have that characteristics. It is easy to produce new varieties of plant with the required characteristics. Suppose we want we like two or three two species different, as I told you, in grafting. So we can have different varieties also. Vegetative plants grow faster than the plants grown from seeds and need less attention during the early stages of growth. If we grow it simply from the seed, it will take more time. But when we grow it from their parts, like stems there or the different stems or tips we have taken, so they will grow much more faster. And fruits without seeds, disease and drought resistant plants can be produced using these methods. Okay, so these are the advantages of vegetative propagation. Now, after that, we come to the sexual reproduction, and this we will discuss in the next session. Right?